Before we finish talking about indentation, I want to show you how you can control this even more. While I usually use the ruler to control indentation, you may prefer to enter specific measurements. You can do this in the paragraph dialog box. To display this box, just click the little arrow in the bottom right corner of the paragraph group. In the paragraph dialog box that appears, you can see the indentation section. From here, you can enter specific measurements for the indents before the text, or special hanging, and first line indents. If you make the changes here and then click OK, they will be applied to the selected text. In addition to indentation, you can also control line spacing. Line spacing in particular is often overlooked. Line spacing is a spacing between sentences and paragraphs in a text box. Let me use the resources slide to show you how line spacing works. To change the line spacing, select the text you want to change. On this slide, we'll select our entire list. On the Home tab, select the line spacing command. A menu appears. We can see that 1.0 has a check mark beside it. That means the selected text is currently single spaced. To change this, just select an option from the menu. You have 1.5, double spaced, 2.5, and triple spaced. Let's see how the slide changes when we select double spaced. See how the spacing between lines increased? Using these menu options from this command is the easiest way to change spacing, but if you want to customize or tweak the line spacing more, you can select line spacing options from the menu. The paragraph dialog box you saw before appears. In the spacing section, you can use the line spacing drop-down menu to select single, 1.5, or double space, all your options you've seen before. If you select multiple, you can enter 3 for triple space or any other larger number. If you select exactly, you can enter specific points. For example, if you're trying to fit more information on a slide, you could select exactly and then use the menu to decrease the points slightly. When you're ready to apply the change, just click OK, and you'll see the new line spacing on the slide. Let's click Undo on the Quick Access toolbar to go back. Sometimes you may want to adjust the line spacing between two lines and not an entire list. For example, on slide 5, I really want there to be more space between the first bullet and the second bullet. If I select all the text, click the line spacing command, and choose 1.5 or 2, it will change the spacing for all the text. To just change the spacing before or after a line, place your cursor where you want to insert the extra spacing. I'll insert my cursor here after the word mail. Then click the line spacing command and select line spacing options. In the paragraph dialog box, locate the before and after fields in the spacing section. The before option changes the line spacing in the area above the selected text or paragraph. The after option changes the line spacing in the area below the selected text or paragraph. I want to add a space after the location of my cursor, so I'll just use the menu arrows to increase this amount. Then click OK, and now you can see the change on the slide. I'll do the same between my second and third bullets, and now my slide looks so much better. Adding line spacing and indentation are two ways that you can improve the look of your slides.